Fox 5 News Now, sponsored by SDCCU.
Good morning, everyone, and welcome into Fox 5 News Now, San Diego's only interactive digital newscast. My name is Matt Meyer, here as always as your host, and we are brought to you, as always, by San Diego County Credit Union. Hey, like I said, it's an interactive show, so as we go today, please let me know what you think about the stories, whether you have questions or comments. You can also let me know where you're watching from or what you're getting up to on this Valentine's Day. Happy Valentine's Day, everybody. Right now, we're looking live at downtown San Diego, and it looks like it's going to be a pretty beautiful day to get out and about and enjoy it. So like I said, let me know where you're watching from or what you're up to today, and certainly do that if you have a question or a comment for me about the show today. You can do that in the Facebook Live or YouTube Live comments. You can also do it in my Twitter mentions, at Matt Meyer News. Well, we're starting off with this live look at downtown San Diego, and you see Petco Park there in the corner of your screen. The super vaccination site at Petco Park is closed today, and this is not by design. This is due to a delayed Moderna shipment of vaccines. If you're not familiar with this story, we learned about this a couple of days ago, but today, Sunday, is the first day that this has actually started to affect our local vaccination sites. Like I said, they were supposed to be open for business today. You see the long lines of cars that form there in this helicopter video when it is open. But unfortunately, a delayed shipment, it was supposed to arrive late earlier this last week. Now it is arriving on Tuesday. That has forced the Petco Park vaccination site to close from Sunday through Tuesday. Appointments are being rescheduled by email. So if you had one, don't worry. They should be reaching out to you. You probably should have already heard from them by now, but they are working through those different appointments. The good news is that at other sites like this superstation that you're seeing this drone video of now in San Marcos, of course, this being a walk-up site as opposed to the driving like you saw at Petco Park, they say that they will be able to, in San Marcos, at least meet their second dose appointments, meaning people who got the first shot and now just need their second dose. They also say that they're going to be able to give some limited first shots to people still, but we're seeing sites across the county at least being affected by this or being aware of this. The good news, again, Chula Vista and La Mesa Superstation say that they are both going to be able to get through Monday without this shipment. So if you had an appointment at those locations, you should not be affected. And there is actually a new site opening today in Vista at the Linda Rhodes Recreation Center. So San Diego has been lauded for its ability to set up the infrastructure to get shots in arms. The problem has been the supply of the vaccine. And again, this delayed shipment disrupting one of San Diego's most notable sites, that one at Petco Park that we were looking at video of just a moment ago. Governor Gavin Newsom was at a site similar to the one like in San Marcos that you're seeing here, but he was up in the Bay Area. He was in San Francisco. We caught up with him a couple of days ago, but I think many of you may not have seen this interview that we got briefly with him, so I wanted to play that for you. He's talking about the importance of vaccinations, not just for opening businesses, but also for getting kids into schools, which has been a hot topic for our show, Fox 5 News Now, and on every broadcast that we've had recently. We have been talking about getting kids back into schools. The CDC says that teachers do not necessarily need to be vaccinated to reopen schools safely. That is the CDC's position. We know that our teachers' unions have been pushing hard for teachers to be vaccinated before they get into school. But Gavin Newsom's point here is that if we get more people vaccinated in the community at large, it will keep case rates down and it will get our businesses back open if they are not already, and kids back in schools. Here's what he had to say.
Making progress in terms of the numbers moving in the right direction, allowing us a little more flexibility in terms of not only business reopenings, but school reopenings. And we need to get our schools reopened in the state of California for our youngest cohorts. We can do that safely. Our kindergarten students, our first and second graders first. We'll get our third, fourth, fifth, and sixth graders in as a second cohort. Our special needs kids, those foster kids, those kids that are homeless need to be in-person instruction safely. We could do that as a state, working with the legislature to support efforts at the local level to provide resources, $6.6 billion of resources to advance that cause, and we continue to make progress on that effort.
So Governor Newsom there, again, talking about the vaccine rollout and its importance for our communities. You're seeing video now from CVS Health. Some of their pharmacies have been able to start distributing vaccines. Right now in San Diego, I checked, all of their appointments are booked up in our region, but I will be sure to update you folks on this continued vaccine rollout, sort of starting and stopping here, but slowly moving along in the county. I see that Kate was asking about the other story that she may have seen in the description of this story about a North County crime scene that local authorities were actually tipped off to via Australia. Strange, sad story. We got new information about this overnight, so I wanted to let you know about this. Yesterday, we were hearing something about it, but we didn't have confirmed details until now. We have learned that the situation unfolded like this. Apparently, a man in Australia contacted Australian police and said that he had got a concerning call from his brother. His brother lives in Carlsbad at the Village Apartments. You're seeing the sign there for that building. Apparently, he contacted his brother and he threatened to kill his girlfriend and to take his own life. When Carlsbad police headed over to the Village Apartments there, they did, in fact, find a murder scene. They found a 33-year-old man and a 44-year-old woman dead. They did not release much further information about where they're at in this investigation. We know, though, that it started with that contact from the Australian authorities around 6 p.m. yesterday, and that when police arrived, they did find those two. They say that they are investigating this as a murder-suicide case. Like I said, a sad, strange case out of Carlsbad. Again, we just got this information earlier this morning, so this happened yesterday evening, but I wanted to let you know about that as we received more details. Again, we'll be following the story closely on Fox5SanDiego.com and on the Fox 5 app, so if you're looking for further updates, that's where we'll be posting those as the day goes on.
Fox 5 News Now, sponsored by SDCCU.
So like I mentioned, I was looking at Kate's comment there asking about that story, and I hope that I got you the information that you were looking for there, Kate. Like I said, this is an interactive news show, so if you're watching for the first time, this is Fox 5 News Now. Thank you so much for joining me. We're looking live right now at downtown San Diego, and I have lots more for you, but I do want to get to at least a few of your comments here because I saw a lot of you folks coming into the chat. I see that Edith is watching. I see that Angie is watching. She's saying hello from San Diego. We're getting this great shot here of downtown San Diego. I see Isaiah is watching from Ramona. I see that James is streaming the show all the way from the UK. That's cool, James. Thank you so much for being here. I see that Sarah is watching in Ireland. This is great. We got an international show going, folks. Keep it coming. Let's see, James watching in Sacramento, Jessica in Claremont, and Elizabeth in Oceanside. A great chat today, lots of you folks, and sorry, I can't get to all of them right now. Henry in San Ysidro, looks like Mars is in Chula Vista. So yeah, thanks folks for tuning in. We have lots more to get to, including news about your Valentine's Day. Again, if you're coming in a little bit late, happy Valentine's Day to you. You're looking live at downtown San Diego, where it's looking like a pretty day out. Businesses are feeling the love on this Valentine's Day. We know that our local businesses have been hurting throughout the pandemic with closures, kind of off and on closures. You're looking at this flower shop here in National City. A lot of last minute Valentine's gift buyers perhaps stopping in this morning. Also, you're looking at a restaurant there in Chula Vista in the Gaslamp District. We're going to have busy restaurants. People, of course, doing outdoor dining with limited seating. But whether you're selling chocolates like you're seeing there on your screen, flowers, or you are a restaurant, our local businesses are saying that they are happy to have the Valentine's Day rush because a lot of them have been just sort of eking by throughout this pandemic. So whatever you do today, I do hope you do it safely, but if you are going to support a business, not a bad time to support one of your small local businesses. Like I said, this flower shop in National City and that restaurant that you were looking at, we actually got to catch up with their teams. I wanted to play a little bit of what they had to say just because I think it sort of captures how important this Valentine's Day rush is for them. And while you're watching, again, let me know what you're up to on this Valentine's Day.
It's been a difficult year. We've been just to go only for a short period of time, and it's nice for us to have that space where we can actually have people here outdoors safely on Valentine's Day.
We try to build that relationship with our customers for sure, and you know, we want them to come back. We want them to stay with us. So it's been kind of nice meeting a lot of new people and all that. So yeah, I think we definitely had the community support for sure.
And so good to hear that from them there. And yeah, like I said, I'll be interested to see what you folks are up to today. And, you know, more than ever, it's going to be a great opportunity to stay safe during the pandemic by staying outside. Luckily, we have so many beautiful parks and the beach here. Our mountains are so close. So maybe you folks are getting out for a hike or a picnic. The weather is going to cooperate. That's the good news. We got some drizzle on Friday and some gustier winds yesterday and even early this morning. But things are calming down a little bit, and it should be beautiful for those of you folks who are enjoying your Valentine's Day outdoors. For more on that, Jason Hanman has your forecast.
Well, after a rather windy Saturday and even windy early this morning, mostly sunny skies and just a beautiful Valentine's Day across the county. A little bit warmer. In fact, temperatures running 3 to 5 degrees above average all across the county. Look at these numbers. Are you planning a nice little picnic outside, a stroll on the beach? Absolutely spectacular weather for it. 62 degrees for the high in Carlsbad, 67 downtown, up to the mid-60s in Mira Mesa and Miramar, 63 degrees in Ramona, 58 in Alpine, 67 in Chula Vista, and 67 degrees in El Cajon. Now, looking ahead to tomorrow, President's Day, clouds will increase late in the day. There's a chance that we pick up a few showers tomorrow night going into Tuesday morning, but it'll clear out pretty quickly on Tuesday, and during the day, nice and dry. Then the warm-up begins. High temperatures returning to the upper 60s at the beaches, looking ahead to Thursday, Friday, Saturday. Inland spots, 67 degrees for the high today, then tomorrow for President's Day, clouds increase. Could be a few showers overnight Monday into early Tuesday. And then the warm-up, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, and Saturday. Temperatures in the mid-70s looking ahead to next weekend. Up in the mountain areas, mid-50s today. 54 degrees for tomorrow, and then you'll see temperatures rise quite a bit looking ahead to Friday and Saturday, with highs getting up to the upper 60s, but not too many complaints on this Valentine's Day Sunday.
Yeah, so thanks to Jason Hanman for your forecast there. I'll get that graphic out of your way so you can take one more look at some of your daytime highs on this Valentine's Day Sunday. I'm glad that you're starting off your morning with me. I see a whole bunch of you in the chat here, so I want to get to at least a few of you. Wanted to say hi to Dave, who's watching from Arizona. He says that he'll be coming out in March to stay at Hotel Del. So Dave, we'll welcome you back. Elizabeth is watching from Chula Vista, and Suzanne is in Encinitas. I see that Grace is watching from Colima, Mexico. Thanks for tuning in. I see that Anne is in Baltimore. And then I had seen a couple of messages here. Oh, I wanted to get to Dana said that she actually got both shots at that Petco Park site. So I'll show you that video again here where they have been getting a lot of people in and out. They're slowly kind of moving through the eligibility tiers, healthcare workers, people 65 and up. Now they're starting to get to some of our folks who have severe underlying health issues, who are maybe a little bit younger. So again, this vaccination site at Petco, Dana saying that she was able to get both of her shots there, and hopefully once it's back up and running on Tuesday, more people, Dana, will have your experience there. Wanted to say hello to a couple of others here. Let's see. I want to say hi to Mary. Thanks so much for tuning in, Mary. Always good to see you. Tony is watching from San Diego. I think it was Mike. I can't find his comment here, but Mike's kind of a smart guy. He says he's watching from his couch. Mike, I hope you're comfortable, and I'm glad that you're tuning in. Thank you so much for being here. Let's see. I see that... Oh, Grace says that she's an English teacher in Mexico, so she's been listening to more English news. That's cool, Grace. Thank you so much for joining me. I speak with some idiosyncrasies, so if something I say sounds funny, it probably just is weird. Let's see, a couple of others here. I want to say hi to Debbie. I see that Herbert is also watching from Rosarito, Mexico. So thanks to you folks who are tuning in from south of the border. One more here. Let's go with Peggy, who's watching from Las Vegas. So thanks, folks. Keep them coming. Do let me know, too, what you are up to today and if you have questions or comments about our stories. Obviously, we got to that that story that we got new information about overnight. We also got some new video into our newsroom overnight that I wanted to bring to you, because you wouldn't have seen this, you would have missed this after you went to bed last night. First of all, an explosion at a home in San Diego blew the garage door off, and revealed what appears to be a hash oil lab. So this was in the Rancho Penasquitos area on Madrigal Street, which is right near the 15 freeway, if you're familiar with that area. You're seeing hazmat coming onto the scene here, and that is because after this explosion blew the garage door off, they found a lot of, well, hazardous materials from this lab. If you're not familiar with what hash oil is, it's a cannabis extract, and authorities say that it's illegal to be making in the fashion that it was likely being made, suspected to have been being made in this garage here. One person who was inside the garage, or at least near enough to the blast at the time, did have burns to their face, and they were taken to UC San Diego, where they have a burn unit there. You're seeing the firefighters carrying out the different chemicals, obviously a lot of flammable materials, and you're seeing that kind of heavier machinery there. So again, hazmat and the arson team from San Diego Fire Rescue are looking into this. As we get updates, of course, we'll be sure to share those on fox5sandiego.com. Also, this car club, if you folks have heard of these car club takeovers, we've been seeing them around town. You see all these skid marks in the intersection. What happened here is a group of people got together to show off their cars. They shut down an intersection, blocking traffic there, and then they do donuts in the middle of the street there. This one drew a large crowd last night. This was in Sereno Valley. Police say there were 100 cars there, as many as 200 people standing around watching the cars, doing donuts, showing off. And apparently one of the people who was watching, a young woman, 25 years old, got too close and was hit by one of those cars that was spinning around in the intersection that you're looking at on your screen there. The driver took off, so police have not found the driver. You did see, though, on your screen there, some officers talking to different people who did stay in the area after this crash. That young woman was taken to the hospital with life-threatening injuries. I talked to police this morning. They were not able to give me a concrete update on her status, but they are looking into whether or not they can find the driver. As of now, they did not report the description of the vehicle or the description of the driver.
Fox 5 News Now, sponsored by SDCCU.
Coming back to you here in the Fox 5 studio, looking one more time at our gorgeous downtown skyline. But hey, let's take a look also from our Mount Soledad camera at our coast this morning. Looking a little bit overcast, but beautiful nonetheless. Maybe some of you are headed to the beach, probably a little cold for swimming, unless you're a surfer, but it should be a pretty day out there for you if you have a Valentine's Day date out and about. Jason Handman got us our forecast. If you missed it, the gist of it is, it's San Diego. Even when it's cooler, it's pretty nice out here. I'm looking at the comments. They keep on coming, and I really do appreciate all of you tuning in. I see that Santiago is watching from Tijuana. I see that Hugo is watching from Cali. Let's see, Adolfo. Oh, hey, Adolfo. I know that they have tuned in before. Hi, good to see you. Let's see, a couple of others here. I see that Nicole was reacting to one of our stories from before. I see that Chris was tuning in. So yeah, thank you folks for getting here, and sorry if I miss your comments. I'm just looking through a couple of others here. I think I got to a good majority of you who let me know where you were watching from. Robert says that he misses San Diego. You know, Robert, I don't know where you live now, but you're always welcome back, my friend. You can enjoy the beautiful view that you're seeing here from our Mount Soledad camera. Hey, Pam is here, and she said something nice to me, so I'm going to read it, because why not? She says that she's watching for the first time, and she likes kind of the personalized, interactive style of the show. I'm so glad to hear that, Pam. That is my goal. I want you folks to know that I care about what you're interested in seeing, and as I go, you may miss a story, or you may have a question for me. Just let me know if there's something specific that you missed, and I'll be happy to let you know about that. If you have questions, I don't always have all the answers, but I'm happy to at least point you in the right direction. So folks, keep the comments coming. I'll check in with you one more time, but I do want to let you know about a couple of more stories that I have my eye on before I get you out here on this Valentine's Day Sunday. And we're going to stick a little positive, because why not? It's Sunday, right? First of all, good news from the San Diego Zoo Safari Park. They say that a troop of gorillas there that actually had the coronavirus have made a full recovery. You might remember this story when it broke, it made national news, because this was the first case in which the virus was known to spread to apes. They actually think that someone on the staff there who was asymptomatic, so they didn't have a way of knowing that they were sick, and interacted with the gorillas there, actually did probably pass it to them. It's 8 gorillas in the troop. They all had mild symptoms, coughing and fatigue, some of the things that we see, you know, in their human counterparts when we get sick from this virus. But the good news is all of them have made a full recovery and they are back in their gorilla forest habitat. Remember, the Zoo Safari Park is back open now just recently, so guests will be able to see the gang. Again, wanted to give you that good news. And again, let's stick with some good news. Let's stick with some animal news. Why not, right? It's our Sunday. I think I've brought you enough doom and gloom. This is a top story on Fox 5, on our Fox 5 app right now, and I think it is pretty self-explanatory. Look at these pups here. So these animals are now at Rancho Coastal Humane Society, but it took the effort of a lot of good folks to get them there. These dogs were actually in the Mexican state of Sonora, and a group called Rescue Phoenix brought them out of there to the States simply because there weren't the resources to take care of the animals there. The shelters were overcrowded, and they weren't getting the care that they needed. This was 18 dogs. Dogs in total, including 7 puppies, and you're seeing how adorable some of these pups were. Now they are at Rancho Coastal Humane Society. Thanks again to that group, Rescue Phoenix, for bringing them there. They are getting, they're going through exams, they're getting vaccinated, and they're getting treated or even getting surgery if necessary, but they will be available for adoption soon. So if you're looking to add a new member to your family, you could probably do pretty well with these cute pups. And finally, animal news of a different sort. You guys are probably going to roll your eyes at me for this one, but the San Diego Gulls are back on Fox 5 this evening, or actually really later this afternoon. They're going to try to keep a 4-game winning streak going. Our Gulls have been playing well. They're going to be playing the Colorado Eagles, and that game starts at 4 p.m. Well, if you've watched the show a couple of times, you know that I always promise to leave you with a smile. And on this special Valentine's Day edition of Fox 5 News Now, I felt like maybe we could use some sage advice from some couples who know a thing or two. Look, the pandemic has been difficult on relationships, but these two couples have been through it all. This is Joanne and Bill here, and you're about to see Marjorie and Dan in just a second. There's Marjorie and Dan. They have been together between the two couples easily over 100 years, 50 plus years between both of these couples, and our Heather Lake got to catch up with them on Friday for some Valentine's Day tips. I thought it was so sweet. It really speaks for itself, so I'm just going to play that for you now.
So first, I spoke to Marjorie and David. Here they are. They just celebrated their 66th wedding anniversary this week. They were glowing, you guys, when I chatted with them on Zoom. This couple spent years sailing together. They say always having an adventure to look forward to has kept them in love. They also say they feel lucky that they've had each other during this time in quarantine.
One little motto I always have is seize the moment, enjoy the day, and don't put off things. You know, saying, well, we'll do that next month or next week. If you don't be going, well, what if? Go, why not?
But most mornings before we do much, we've maybe eaten our breakfast, we will stand up in our little living room and kiss each other.
And hug. We are big huggers.
I love that. Well, next up, we talked to Joanne and Bill. Here they are. They're celebrating 52 years of marriage, and they say humor is an important aspect in everyday life. I think we can all agree. And remembering all the good times, they say also giving each other their space is their secret to their lasting marriage.
Well, be patient above all. I mean, the person you're trapped with in this pandemic is somebody you love and you've known for years. It's often fun to draw on favorite memories and trips and to look at albums of things we've done. And to just remind ourselves that this is, while it's confining, it's temporary, and we're gonna have a much easier going life eventually.
I would also say get silly. Do something fun. Say it's going to be, okay, we're all going to make goofy hats tonight, or put on the Beatles and we're going to all
dance,
you know, and move around, that you and in a sense become a child yourself with your children, you know, that you're going to have a treasure hunt in the house, that, and you're all going to go on the treasure hunt, or that you really have to become playful.
Oh, the sweet hug. How good is that, folks? I mean, sometimes these days it can get a little dark, it can get a little stormy in our current pandemic lifestyle, but I think that those two share some sage advice. I want to take a second to give a shout out to my Valentine, who I love very much, and I appreciate watching. And I want to give a big shout out to all of you folks. You, in a way, you are all my Valentine. Thank you for joining me on this edition of Fox 5 News Now. About to wrap up for you, but I do want to get to just a couple more of you because I can, and you deserve it. Let's see. I see that Dimitri is watching from Colombia. Thank you for tuning in. Lisa's watching from Oceanside. I see that Brian is watching from Arkansas, but he misses his hometown of San Diego. There was also a comment that I wanted to get to. Oh, I see. So Mary was asking about any updates on the story of a missing mom in Chula Vista. So let me pull up our website for you here. Let me see if I can get this. And bear with me for a second, folks, because I do want to get this information to you if I can. Let's see here. We do have a story about that. What you're referring to is Maya Millett. She's a missing Chula Vista mom. She's been missing for about 6 weeks now. There we go. Okay, so I've got her story pulled up here for you. And again, thanks for bearing with me. I'm doing these things live with you, but I do want to get you this information as I can. So I just pulled up this most recent story that we have on that case. So to answer your question, Mary, unfortunately, we don't have any concrete updates, but what we do know is that the family is actually out in the Glamis sand dunes. So I'll leave the story up here on the site if you do want to go check that out. But essentially, the family says that they got some kind of tip that it's possible that this missing mom of three, again, she's been missing for over a month now, that she may have been somewhere in the area of the sand dunes, that there may be a reason for them to head out that way. So they did organize a search party that headed out that way. Again, the Glamis sand dunes, if you're not familiar, it's here in California, but miles away, about 150 miles away from San Diego. The family says that they had camped there frequently in the past, so there was some connection to that area. They were a little bit tight-lipped in terms of further notice on that, but they did say again that they were there this weekend. I know that they actually organized a search party around 10 a.m. on Sunday. So, of course, if I get more information about that, Mary, I will bring that to you folks on fox5sandiego.com. And if you get our Fox 5 app, you can also get breaking news alerts. We would certainly send one if we get any news in that case. I know that that's one that a lot of you folks here who watch the show have been following closely. So yeah, thank you for your question. That's what we know about that. Again, you can find that story there on our website. If you're looking for more, you can search her name in the search bar on our website there, and you'll be able to find that information. Do want to say hello to a couple of others before I head out here on this Sunday. Elizabeth is tuning in from Vista and says happy Valentine's Day to everybody. Let's see, I might repeat some of these. So if you get a double shout out, you know, just you know, take that as a sign of good luck. I see that we've got someone tuning in from El Cajon. I see that Joseph is tuning in and singing the praises of San Diego there. I agree with you, Joseph. He was replying to somebody who called San Diego America's finest city. Take a look at that beautiful shot of Mount Soledad. We were looking at our downtown skyline earlier. It certainly is. I agree with you there. Final shout out of the day goes to Kim, who is watching in Rancho Bernardo. Thank you so much for tuning in, everybody. I will be back next Saturday and Sunday at 10 a.m., and I appreciate seeing you there. So until then, have a great Valentine's Day. Do stay safe, folks. If you go out, mask up, keep your distance. We can do this together. Again, until next Saturday and Sunday, I hope you have a great week.